So first off, I've seen a lot of comments about this image. It debuted last night on social media while I was seeing Solo, damn it! But anyway, and I had to post my Solo review this morning, so I'm getting to it now, I'm sorry. But some people were like, oh, this is shutting up the haters. This proves how good the suit looks. And I'm like, this just proves that those other photos from the set were accurate because this looks exactly like that suit. Only the lightning bolt lights up, which, you know, I have to admit does help. But I want to reiterate some of the comments I've said earlier about this movie, which I think it's becoming more and more clear that I was correct. And then just, you know, talk about what the suits at Warner Brothers might be thinking. Okay, so as you can see from the thumbnail for this video, I think the question is this Deadpool or is it Elf? And I think the answer, by the way, is super obvious. It's Elf and maybe Big as well. Because, you know, of course, Billy Batson that's actually a child, you know, in an adult superhero body. And we'll see if in 2018 you can handle some of the things that the first Big did, let's just say got away with, actually, when that movie came out. But anyway, I think that maybe Warner Brothers thinks they have Deadpool here, which I think they're in for a very big surprise if that's what they think. But first off, one of the things that really struck me about this poster when I first saw it, this image, was that's me drinking a large soda. I love me a large soda or an iced tea with a straw. It's a real joy, actually. So I could totally relate to that. But then I was like, what are you drinking, Billy? Are you an iced tea guy or a soda guy? How can we further bond? And then I was like, is that just a giant cup of juice? I guess it's a play on a sippy cup, or growing boys need their juice, maybe? I don't know, but I think that Warner Brothers should have just put a product placement deal together for this poster, because that just looks weird. You're like, why are you drinking so much juice? And who drinks red juice? Maybe it's high C, maybe it's not nutritional at all, because he's an adult and he can pick whatever beverage he wants. I think you can see where the humor for this movie is likely headed. Also, he seems to be wearing eyeliner. I don't know if you guys felt that way. And that's a lot of hair product too. And his eyebrows, I don't know, maybe it's just because of the pixelation of the image. It's not a high res image. But, you know, I think that, Billy Batson has some interesting ideas about how, you know, some adults get ready to go for the day. Or, you know what, maybe he's very woke. I don't know. But I just think, well, speaking of Zachary Levi, of course, you can't miss him in this photo, and he's adorable. He should stand next to every promotional piece for this movie, because he helps. His joy at not just finally being in a major movie, but starring in one, is just so endearing. It makes me want to like this movie, and maybe I will. But it will be like Elf or Big, and I have to tell you, even adjusted for inflation with Big, you might be like, hey, maybe Big was a super hit. It was a very big hit, but it wasn't a superhero-sized hit, and I think that distinction is important. So one has to question why Warner Brothers would not only take this approach with the character and hire a horror director to do it. They're like, who should make this comedy? I know, right? But to make a Shazam movie even in the first place. And I have to say, while I can totally see Dwayne Johnson mixing it up with this version of the character, it's not what The Rock has been promising us that he's been cooking over the last couple of years when it comes to Black Adam, right? Promises were made, and it looks like promises are being broken. And, you know, if DC and Warner Brothers knew this is what they were going to do, they should have said, like, stop telling people, you know, The Rock, what your Black Adam's going to be like, because he's not going to be like that. The characters have to match, even if Black Adam debuts in another movie. This is still the hero to his villain, so they have to match. The suits have to be similar. They have to have a similar vibe. Now, with this image, you know, so you might be like, well, Grace, it seems so obviously that it's Elf or Big. Why do you think that it might be Deadpool at all? Why do you think Warner Brothers might even be going down that path? Well, the casting of Ryan Reynolds' light, Zachary Levi, I think is one such, you know, piece of evidence. Plus, that, you know, the way this character is looking at the audience with like a knowing wink, it reminds me a little bit of the Deadpool marketing, you know, the most recent marketing like that. To be fair, Big and Elf also had similar ad campaigns, you know, looking at the audience with that mischievous, playful feel. But I think that, you know, Warner Brothers might be like, what if we made a Deadpool movie that had wider appeal, though, because so families could go and see it, but it'll still be super meta, and he'll be commenting on superheroes the whole movie, because as we've seen from behind the scenes photos and footage, you know, they've made him very much a fan of the Justice League, and they're featuring Justice League toys. And he'll, you know, have a fanboy moment when, you know, maybe Superman shows up, which is rumored, et cetera, et cetera. So they were thinking, you know, mass appeal Deadpool. But I just, you know, there might be something to say for that, but then you don't want to come across as a Deadpool ripoff either. I think there's, you know, I think the bottom line for me is with this image is that it cements, again, a lot of what I felt about this project all along. And that's that Zachary Levi is just, you know, I feel so bad. Look at him looking at me while I say this. I'm so sorry. But he's just too TV. He's too small of an actor. I think he's very funny. He's very talented. But he's no Ryan Reynolds, and he never has been. And I don't think anybody felt that he was the next Ryan Reynolds, if only he could get a big break. So I think that if they wanted to do an L for a big, they should have gotten someone of the caliber of Hanks or Farrell to star in said movie. So I hope families are into this. It comes out like the beginning of April next year. That's not a super competitive release date, but it also just kind of misses spring break. So oddly, they're releasing a family-friendly movie when school is in session. Again, weird choice. But we'll see how this does. I suspect not great. And I think, you know, it could be a solid, but when Marvel is hitting home run after home run out of the park, you can't even retrieve those balls. Why would, I'm going to try for a sports metaphor here, why would DC just be happy with a single? I'm not even going to call this a double. Maybe if they're lucky, it's going to be a double. Did I do it? Did I get the sports metaphor right? All right. Thank you for talking about this with me. We will reserve complete judgment. Well, actually, until we see the actual movie itself. But the trailers will be certainly very interesting to see. All right. Write your thoughts down below. And of course, as always, you can check out some more videos, including that solo review, right now.